Police put a Fort Myers apartment complex on lockdown today after an Army veteran with PTSD called police claiming someone was after him. The heartbreaking scenario played out at the park at Veneto Apartments off Solomon Boulevard.
The police told NBC2's Trent Kelly this could have ended much differently if not for their specialized training on how to deal with our veterans just coming back from war.
If you come over here, you're going to get shot. We don't want you to get shot, so stay over this area.
An urgent warning from Fort Myers police.
Like, oh my God, what is going on?
After an Army veteran living at the park at Veneto Apartments barricades himself inside, all while armed with a gun.
This guy, he's a war veteran. He talks to himself sometimes.
While neighbors describe the veteran as a nice guy, police say they got a call from him around 8 this morning, claiming someone was coming after him.
Delusional issues, basically. Thought several people were out to get him.
After confirming the vet suffers from post-traumatic stress disorder, negotiators built a rapport with the man, and after 3 hours, were able to coax him out safely.
We're hearing a lot about this going on in the nation, you know, with all these guys coming back, so it's tough, and we train for it.
Training that will surely continue, as mental health experts say they're seeing more veterans with PTSD, many of whom don't even know they're suffering.
Typically, when someone is experiencing PTSD symptoms, it's either avoidance or numbing of the memory or that trauma.
Experts say the best way to deal with someone suffering from PTSD is to offer your support rather than run away.
When people don't know about something, they fear what they don't know, so they don't say anything at all. And I think the best thing you can do is offer someone that help.
Help one veteran is now receiving, even if it took a 3-hour standoff.
This is not going away. You know, the more that the men and women come back, you know, the more we're going to see this.
In Fort Myers, Trent Kelly, NBC2.